Hello everyone, I hope you're well. I want to use the next few minutes to be honest with you and tell you the truth. Because until I get this off my chest, it will continue to weigh me down, so to speak. I'm fully expecting to get a lot of downvotes and criticism for this, but I'm fine with that. I feel like the time has come to draw a line under the Iconoclast. This will be the last video I ever make under that identity, and I will also be ceasing all activity under that name within the coming weeks. Why have I decided to do this? Well, it's pretty simple. I don't have anything more to offer as a public figure, if I can even call myself that. My biggest strength was making accessible and shareable content that would help bring people over to our side, to give them the confidence to recognize that they weren't alone in what they were thinking and what they believed. And I'm immensely proud of the work I've done. I get messages all the time from people who saw my videos and then took the next step after viewing them, and I appreciate every single person who ever watched and followed me. There have also been some events in my personal life that have informed this decision as well, that have helped me prioritize things, but believe me, I've been thinking about this for a while now. Even at the height of my channel, I knew it had a shelf life. Either it would get banned or I'd get burnt out. Funnily enough, both of those things happened. Before my channel got taken down, I was basically mentally checked out anyway. I'd said all I wanted to say, and it was getting to the point where my daily life was getting me down. Waking up and intentionally exposing myself to bad news, staring into a laptop all day trying to find something to make content about. I didn't want that to be my life. If I wanted to, I know I could continue doing what I was doing before only on Bitchute, and I know I'd probably make a decent living doing it, enough to pay the rent and feed myself at the very least. But if I was to do that now, it would be forced and inauthentic. I'm not some big brain who dives into political theory and philosophy, and I don't want to spend my time singing to the choir. I also feel like you, the viewers, are tired of all this as well. On some level, you want something more, and so do I. The current times we live in aren't the best. 2020 was an illuminating year for many of us. For me, it proved that spending time trying to red pill the normies was ultimately pointless. The only thing that matters is power. If you have that, the normies will do whatever they are told. There's a reason why when you walk down the street, you see these people wearing masks and keeping their distance from you. They believe what the television tells them. And even if they are skeptical, there's no real desire to put up a fight because they just want to be left alone to get on with their lives. The problem we have as a movement is we have no power whatsoever. The cards are stacked against us, and no, it isn't fair. We've been herded onto social media platforms where we spend our days fighting with the other side, and oftentimes, too often, fighting with ourselves. It is entirely beneficial for the establishment to keep us preoccupied with Twitter or Telegram or YouTube, because they know as long as we are there, we are no threat to them. On an individual level, this movement is full of people who haven't achieved anything. And before I go on, I don't want this to come across in the wrong way. I don't want to offend anyone because that's not my intention. But I have to call it like I see it. How many people in nationalism have social and financial capital in their personal lives? How many of them keep fit and healthy? How many of them are striving to improve their immediate situations to provide for their family? How many of them have families at all? Yes, there are some, of course, and there are people striving to achieve those things. But from my experience, being prominent in this scene for the last 4 years, there are far too many people who put all of their time and energy into squabbling with people online, in complaining about the state of the world but doing nothing to improve it, in receding into chat rooms and forums, and I don't think that makes for a healthy movement that can actually do anything. When I look at myself, I see many of these problems, so I'm not just attacking people here, I see it in me. The truth is, I don't want to be a powerless individual. I want to attain a certain standard in my life. I want to improve my situation and build myself up both professionally and personally to a point where, in the future, I will be more able to affect change in the real world, just because of my status in life. This movement, if it wants to be successful, needs to be made up of successful, healthy, and ambitious people. The longer we stay domesticated online in these little corners, the harder our fight will be. That's not to say, by the way, that networking with like-minded people online or making content is useless. I think it is valuable. But right now, there is a complete imbalance, and people have forgotten to take care of themselves. The goal of the online space, I believe, going into the future, should be to build community and collectivize us as a people, where we can support each other and look out for each other. And there are definitely people and groups striving to achieve this. Our type of politics attracts people on the fringes of society, and it always has. But we must encourage ourselves to get better in every aspect of our lives, instead of simply accepting that fringe status. This is the core reason why I'm ending the Iconoclast. I want to lead by example, and in the future be able to serve this movement in much more effective ways in the real world. I'm not renouncing nationalism, I'm trying to make it better. Sometimes some uncomfortable truths are necessary. I feel it's important to say that I haven't been forced into doing this, I haven't been threatened or tapped up, this is all on me. I still believe in everything I believe in, and in the future I think those beliefs will become more mainstream. I'd also like to clarify, I'm not in any sort of trouble, nor am I suffering from an illness or depression or anything like that. I'm not black-pilled. I haven't lost hope. I just need to do this for me. And if anything I've said in this video resonates with you, I hope you will also take the action and make the changes you need to make as well. I'm not disappearing off the face of the earth. I'll still be around in some way. There's nothing much more to say now, other than thank you to every single person who has ever supported me, encouraged me, and gotten involved. There are some truly great people in this scene, and I've made friends for life. I don't want to end this with silly platitudes or some lame motivational speech, so I'll spare you from that. But for me, I've done all I can do for now. I wish you all nothing but happiness until we meet again, which we will. Goodbye.